Uh-oh. Uh-oh, she's gonna fly away. Hello there, my beautiful lovely. You're biting me again. What are you doing? You can't eat me. You can't eat me. Hello there, my beautiful, lovely, talented, and delightful internet friends. Welcome back to my channel. This is my co-host, Sophie, who is apparently very hungry for flesh today. So there is something sitting right below the camera right now that you cannot yet see that I am simultaneously ridiculously excited and also unexpectedly a little bit terrified of. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I am Footless Joe. My name is Joe. I'm missing a foot. I feel like context is important for this video. So for those of you who do not know my story, when I was 13 years old, I fell off a horse. I shattered my ankle. I had to have surgery. No big deal. Okay, I had to have another surgery because it didn't heal right. Then I had to have it fused because all the cartilage in my ankle disappeared. And this went on for quite some time. I had a lot of surgeries, a lot of procedures, always had some ankle pain in varying degrees, and it got worse and worse over the years. So by the time I was 27, just about 2 years ago, I made the decision to go ahead and chop it off because there was no hope left for it to be functional. Any activity that I enjoyed doing, I either couldn't do anymore or it was really, really painful to do so. I was on a lot of pain medication, and sometimes it's better to let go of something that's hurting you and bringing you pain than to hold on to it just for the sake of keeping it. So I had my amputation in October of 2018. But here's the thing, guys. During all of those years of surgeries and being on crutches and whatnot, I was always able to still do most things I wanted to do, except for one thing. There's one thing that I have not been able to actually do since I was 13, that I have dreamed of doing and that I have been restricted from for almost 2 decades of my life. And it's something that I've dreamed of doing, and it was a reason, it was a small reason, it was like a 2% reason. It was like the cake, not the cake, it was like the icing on top of the cake. If I had an amputation, maybe one day I'd be able to do this. And those of you who have watched my channel for a little while probably know what I'm talking about. But before I announce this thing, yes, I'm gonna do the annoying YouTuber thing where I make you wait just another second. I would like to introduce you to our sponsor today. I'm gonna need a really good hair swoosh to start this part off. No, that wasn't it. A huge thank you to Function of Beauty for sponsoring today's video. Hair care, much like skin care, is not one size fits all, which is where Function of Beauty comes in. They create 100% customizable hair care and body care to suit whatever your needs are. I took a 2-minute quiz online to fill out what kind of hair I had, what kind of hair needs I had, what color I wanted to be, what scent I wanted, how strong I wanted that scent, which I think is a fantastic feature, especially if you get migraines from smells like I do. You even get to choose what name you would like printed on the bottle, which makes me feel extra fancy and special. As you know, I live in Colorado, but what you might not know is that Colorado is seriously lacking in any moisture. Our air is crazy, crazy dry here, so my skin and my hair are always desperate for moisture, and it's been difficult to find a good shampoo and conditioner that cater to that. This is the answer. I really appreciate Function of Beauty for allowing me to customize this specifically to the climate and the type of hair that I have. Also, I can make it whatever pretty color I want, and the color is always gonna be purple because purple is the best color. Function of Beauty has also recently released the world's first customizable body care, so check out their body lotion and their body wash as you are also customizing your hair solution. Follow my link below for 20% off your first order and let me know what color or scent or style you choose in the comments down below. Okay, it's time. It's time for the big reveal, something that I have been thinking about pretty much nonstop for the past 2 years since I had my leg amputation. I don't know if you know this, but if you are an amputee and you want to run, you're gonna need a running blade. And these things are not cheap and they are not covered by insurance. And I always knew one day somehow, maybe I'd save enough money or raise enough money or find a grant program or something like that. And then I made a friend who's about my height, similar weight, similar age, also missing a leg, and happen to have an extra running blade. I am not kidding about this. I am so freaking excited. Check this out, guys. I have a freaking running blade. I can learn to run. Look at all this glorious, beautiful carbon fiber. Check out that Nike tread we got going on. Side note, I never thought about needing different kinds of tread for a running blade, but apparently there's different like running blade shoes that you could stick on this thing depending on what kind of activity that you're doing. For those of you who have been here for quite some time, you know that running has been a huge goal of mine. It's been something that I've looked forward to when things are really rough. It's always been on my one day I will list. I just like holding this. This is just really cool. Ah, it's so cool to me that I'm going to have the opportunity to learn. So before I go any further, let me just say thank you so freaking much. I don't wanna like brandish this. To my friend Annika, you can find her on Instagram under Annika the Amputee, for giving me one of her extra running blades. This is such an incredible gift, and I hope you know how grateful I am to you truly. So let's talk about next steps with this puppy right here. So there's a few things that need to happen before I can actually start trying to learn how to run. Apparently, it feels like jumping on a trampoline because these things are kind of springy when you're standing on them. It's gonna be really interesting. I need a running socket because this cannot attach to my current leg. It's gonna attach in the back, like so, and needs a dedicated socket. So I talked to my prosthetist up in Denver, Zach, and he said he would make me one. So I'm gonna be going up there in the next couple weeks. We're gonna make a running blade socket. We're gonna attach this puppy to the back of it, and then I'm going to try to take steps a little bit faster than walking. Now for everyone watching, and I'm sure there are a few of you who are thinking, you know, I'm excited for you, Joe, but running's the worst. For instance, my husband hates running. He thinks it's the worst activity. He would rather do pretty much anything else. I know that that is the case for a lot of people, but when you haven't been able to do something, any of your adult years, any of your teenage years, I love doing things. I love being active. I love pushing myself. I get so much joy from that. And running is an activity that I've always been restricted from because before my amputation, I had a fused ankle and technically I could run on it, but it was very painful and also it was highly not recommended to do so because I was gonna damage it and wear it out faster. And so I really couldn't run. And now I have a chance. Now I do wanna say that I am ridiculously excited and also a little bit terrified. This is something I've been looking forward to for so long because I am so jazzed about this that I am a little bit concerned that maybe it's not gonna work out, like maybe we won't get the right socket fit, or maybe running's gonna be too much pressure on my residual limb and it's gonna hurt too much and I'm not gonna be able to run, and all the things, like the ifs, ands, or buts, the things that could happen are kind of going through my head. But you know what? There's no way to find any of this out without just doing it. And so fear to the side of the road, I'm gonna get this made. I'm gonna learn how to run and it's gonna be freaking awesome. And I am so excited that you are here for this journey, because I made quite a few videos recovering from surgeries when all I could do was sit on the couch and talk, and you guys were here for it then, and now I might actually be able to do one of the things that I've dreamed about for years. I can't wait to see how that goes and to bring you guys along for this journey. So with that being said, be on the lookout here in a couple weeks for getting my running blade socket and learning how to run. That's gonna be coming up soon. Oh my God, I'm so excited. And thank you again, Annika. Thank you so much for this incredible gift. Thank you again to Function of Beauty for sponsoring this video. You guys are absolutely fantastic. As I said, I would highly recommend checking them out. Use the discount code down below. And with that being said, thank you for being here. Thanks for getting excited with me and caring about this part of my journey. It means the world to me. A huge thank you to my patrons for continuing to sponsor and enable me to make these videos. I truly appreciate each and every one of you. And to you watching this video right now, I love you guys. I'm thinking about you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys. Have heard from the sky.